Welcome to another video from DIY Daily. Just put together a quick video, just running you through a bit of information for a fault code on this 2017 Audi A4. And just show you quickly, if we just turn the ignition off and back on again, we've got a warning that's coming up relating to the Ad Blue. Just the Ad Blue fault there. Now we've got plenty of Ad Blue in the tank itself, but we've done a full scan with the top-down diagnostic machine. It did have some other fault codes in it, in the Ad Blue ECU and the engine ECU relating to the Ad Blue system that you could clear out, but immediately the one that comes back is this one here, just going into the engine ECU. You can see we've got P21CA Reductant control module supply voltage. We have got some other faults in here, but they are relating to different issues. The main ones that we're looking at is this reductant tank and the reductant tank ECU there as well. You can see we've got exactly the same fault code in that. So I'm just going to show you now, if you've got this fault code, it's probably worth checking what we found at fault on this one relating to the ECU. I'll show you where it is and the issue that we've got with the ECU. It's not to say that it's definitely this problem with yours, but if you've got this fault code, it might be worth checking the item. But I'll just show you in a minute where it's located and what we've actually found wrong with it. So and just before we get into the video, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, just click on the red subscribe button below to make sure you don't miss out on any future content. But we'll just get it up in the air now and just show you where the ECU is located. Just coming up from underneath the back of the vehicle, got a spare wheel well here. And then just at the back corner here, you've just got this little trim you need to take down. Really easy to get off, just a couple of plastic 10mm studs on there. And you can just see we've got the Ad Blue pump there. And the ECU here, which just simply screws up. Now this is the ECU is where we've got the problem. We've got some water damage inside there, which we'll show you in a minute. But just to get it off, just simply undo this clip there, just pull that back, pop it off. I will also just display over the top of the video a wiring diagram for the Ad Blue ECU, just so you can check the supply fuses as well. Obviously, this one's got corrosion in the unit, so this can cause a lot of different fault codes as well. So now we've got the ECU itself off. Now they do suffer with these ECUs. They're in a quite bad location, but some of the bits that they suffer with, there's this little hole at the back there. Sometimes they can get water in through there. There's a sticker on the other side. But all you need to do to get it off, there's four screws, but they are quite tight. You can just see you have to sort of pry away at it to get it off because it's bonded on. And once we've got the cover off, and just see this one hasn't actually leaked through where the hole is, where the sticker is. It's actually still intact there, but it's actually leaked through around the sides there, and you can see quite a bit of corrosion build up. But the main area where I've spotted a load of corrosion, you can just see on this side of the ECU, there's loads of bits of corrosion on there. So now we haven't got a new ECU yet. A new ECU, you've got to get it from the dealer. It's got to be coded as well, but I'm fairly sure this is going to be the issue that we've got. So but obviously with this corrosion on there, this definitely needs sorting out before we go any further. So we'll just sort of put the video on there just to share a bit of information. If anyone's got that same fault code, it's definitely worth looking into this. Just sort of put it on there for the location of the ECU as well. So just a quick update to the video, it's 3 days later now. We've actually got a new module, got a brand new module direct from Volkswagen, fitted the unit, plugged it in. All I've done is simply clear all the fault codes. I haven't done any coding. I had a quick look with the top-down diagnostic machine. I've got the snap-on machine plugged into it at the minute, just to see if it was on there. I couldn't find any coding options for the actual ECU, so all I've done is fit it, clear all the fault codes. I'll give it a good run. It's running absolutely spot on now. It'd allow me to clear the codes out straight away, whereas before it was a permanent code. As soon as you tried clearing it, it was straight back in there. So it looks like if you actually fit a new module, you'd probably get away without actually getting it configured. I would doubt you'd be able to fit a second-hand one. I'm pretty sure if you fit a second-hand one, that is where the coding will cause an issue. But it looks like, I just thought I'd update the video. Obviously, I'll just show you quickly on the snap-on machine rather than the top-down machine, but you can see we've got no fault codes in the engine ECU there. And if we go down to the reductant control module, should just see got zero codes in there as well. Now the unit itself is quite expensive, but just thought I'd put this video on there. So if you've got that fault code, it's not saying it's definitely that. You need to obviously check the wiring and then fuses as well. I'll just overlay a wiring diagram for it, but if you just want to just simply check that and take it apart, it's well worth just checking to see if that's more corroded in there. So, but yeah, hope the video helped. If it did, give it a quick thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.